Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. In this video I'm going to explain how to use the ASHRAE 55 tab of the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool. The ASHRAE 55 tab is divided in two main sections. On the left we have the inputs and on the right we have the outputs of the model. The first thing that you can choose from is either to use the PMV method or to use the adaptive method. I will cover the adaptive method in another video. So let's go back to the PMV method. Then you can specify the five main input parameters. And you can specify first the operative temperature, the airspeed, relative humidity, metabolic rate, and clothing level. If you don't know exactly what each of these variables mean and what it actually represents, I would encourage you to just click on the link on the name of the variable. And then you will be redirected to Wikipedia, where you can find out more. Alternatively, you can always consult ISO standards or the ASHRAE 55 standard, where you can read more about each of the variables. It is very important to note that the airspeed that you enter in the model here is actually the measure airspeed. ASHRAE 55 recommends that you measure the airspeed at three different heights based on the body position of the participant. So if the person is sitting, you should measure the airspeed at 0.1, 0.7 and 1.1 meters and then eventually average these three values. On the other hand, if the person is standing, then you measure the airspeed at three different heights, which are 0.1, 1.1 meters and 1.7 meter. And again, you should average these values. And the same is true also for the air temperature and the mean radiant temperature, which should also be measured at three different heights. Our tool automatically calculates the activity generated airspeed. If you want to find out more about what the activity generated airspeed is, you can click here at the bottom of our tool. And then you will be redirected to our documentation page in which we explain what the self-generated airspeed is. Basically, if the metabolic rate is higher than 1 MET, then consequently, we just need to take into account that the fact that the person has a MET higher than 1 increases the airspeed that the person is actually perceiving. And the metabolic rate is also affecting the clothing value. Consequently, the value that you're going to enter into the tool is the value that you have observed, but then our tool automatically calculates the dynamic clothing value. Again, if you want to find out more about the dynamic clothing value, I would encourage you to click on this link here at the bottom under the chart and then read the official documentation. So let me show you an example of how the metabolic rate affects actually the dynamic clothing level and the airspeed. I'm going to increase the metabolic rate here. And then I'm going to see how these two values change. I'm also going to increase the airspeed here. So I, for instance, enter a value of 0.3 meters per second, but the tool is actually telling me that based on this metabolic rate, which is equal to 1.5 MET, my relative airspeed is now considered to be 0.45 meters per second. And the dynamic clothing has decreased because as the person moves and it has a higher metabolic rate, it's pumping air under his clothes. So the clothes provide less insulation to his body. And consequently, the dynamic clothing is 0.53, even though we enter a clothing value of equal to 0.61 clo. The ASHRAE 55 for airspeed greater than 0.1 meters per second is using a slightly different approach from the PMV model, the classic PMV model developed by Fenger. As you can see here, the ASHRAE 55 is first calculating a cooling effect. This cooling effect is subtracted from the air temperature and the mean radiant temperature. The air velocity is set to equal to 0.1, All this is done in the backend, and then eventually the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool uses this value to calculate the PMV value. Our tool is actually showing you the cooling effect. All these calculations are done in the backend, but it's very important to understand which are the main differences between the PMV method as shown in the ASHRAE 55 and the one reported in the ISO, because the two values based on the same inputs are going to be different. So you need to understand the differences, and then eventually it's up to you to choose which model to use. We then have the relative humidity, which you can change this input parameter to humidity ratio, dew point, wet pulp temperature or vapor pressure as you want. Then we have the metabolic rate. If you don't know typical metabolic rates, you can always use this drop down menu here that you have on the right, and then you can choose among one of these inputs, and then you can find the type of activity that matches more closely the one of the participant in your space. And finally, you need to specify the clothing level. The clothing level, again, you can enter the value in CLO, or alternatively, you can use this drop-down menu here to choose among different clothing ensembles. On the right side, you see visualized and you get the results. So let's see what we get here. So for these sets of inputs, we get a PMV of minus 0.16, a PPD, which is the predicted percentage of dissatisfied people, of 6%, the sensation is neutral, and the SET, which is the standard effective temperature, estimated is 24.8 degrees. Again, if you don't know what these values or these indexes are, I would encourage you to look at the ASHRAE 55 or the ISO 7730, in which you can read more about the PMV, PPD, and thermal sensation. At the bottom here, we have the psychrometric chart. We can move with the mouse across the chart, and we see the air property of the moist air shown here at the top, and then we can move the mouse around to check the condition where our cursor is. In the center here, we get the point in red. This is the point that we have actually selected. As you can see, it's 25 degrees, 50% relative humidity, and so forth. And in blue, we get the comfort region. The comfort region is defined as between minus 0.5 PMV and plus 0.5 PMV, according to the ASHRAE 55 standard. In this figure, we are assuming that the dry bulb air temperature and the mean radiant temperature are exactly the same. At the bottom here, you can also read the limits of applicability of the standards and to which occupants it actually applies. Sometimes you don't want to use the operative temperature, but instead you want to use the air temperature and the mean radiant temperature. You can do that by changing the type of chart here, so moving from the psychrometric operative temperature to the psychrometric air temperature, and then here you can untoggle this checkbox here. Now you can specify individually both the air temperature, which we're going to set to 23, and the mean radiant temperature, which is going to be equal to 27. And then we get a new value of PMV. Please note that now this psychrometric chart has changed. On the x-axis, now we no longer have the operative temperature, but instead we have the dry bulb air temperature. And consequently, across the whole chart, we are considering that the mean radiant temperature stays the same. This is in many cases wrong, because you will hardly find a space which is a 14 degrees and then eventually it has a mean radiant temperature of 27 degrees. Of course, it's up to you to choose whichever chart you want to use, but I just wanted to highlight that. So that's why we set as the default the psychrometric with the operative temperature, which combines the dry bulb and the mean radiant temperature. You're not limited to visualize your results on the psychrometric chart, but you can also choose among different type of chart. For instance, you can select the relative humidity versus air temperature, which also plots the comfort region, but on a different axis. And maybe for some of you, maybe easier to interpret this chart, because you have the dry bulb temperature here on the x-axis and we have the relative humidity on the y-axis. Then we have the airspeed versus operative temperature. This shows us how the comfort region changes as the airspeed increases. So of course, if you increase the air velocity, then eventually the comfort region moves towards higher temperature, because higher air speed increases the heat losses from our skin to the environment. You can also visualize the thermal heat losses versus the air temperature. So these are the heat losses and heat gains calculated with the PMV model, and you can visualize them here, and you can toggle on and off different factors. So here we have the total latent heat, total sensible heat, total heat losses, and the metabolic rate. And where the total heat losses meet the metabolic rate, that's actually the comfort temperature. So in this case, it's roughly 26 degrees. I switch back to the operative temperature psychrometric chart. Our tool also allows you to create a custom ensemble. So if your participant is wearing clothes that are not listed here in this drop-down, don't worry, you can create our tool to create a custom ensemble. You have to select all the appropriate element of clothing, such as the, in my case, I can select the shoes, I can select underwear, I can select shorts and t-shirt, and then I can click on set cloth value, and this is going to update the cloth value here in my tool. Alternatively, I can also predict the clothing level based on the temperature at 6 a.m. I select a temperature of 20 degrees, and this is going to calculate the clothing level. I'm not going to explain what is the solar gain on occupants in this video, because I'm going to explain it in another video. You can also change the pressure of that location. Right now we are considering a standard sea level pressure, but of course you can change that. And if you're not familiar with SI unit, you can convert to IP units, and you can toggle between units by just clicking on this button here. You can reset to the default values if you want to. You can also save the input value. So let's say that you have 27, you want to set 27 degrees, you want to save it. Then you can reset to the default, but then you can reload what you have saved and you go back to 27 degrees. And finally, if there is a condition that you want to share with someone else, so you want them to quickly go to that condition that you have defined, you can also share the current condition. So I can change the input variables here, and then I can click on share. This is going to create a link that you can just copy, and then you can send it via email or paste it in another tab of your browser. And this is going to open the same condition that you can see here on the screen. If you want to find out more, and if you want to read more about our tool, you can click on documentation and you will be directed to our documentation website, which we have information about all the different pages that we have. There is an help section, how you can contribute, and all the changes that we have applied to the tool. This is extremely important, so I want to spend a few words about this. Here in the change log, we have all the fixes that we have made throughout the years to our tool. So check that, and you can also check the current version of the tool here at the bottom. We're currently at version 2.4.2. So always reference the version that you are using when you are actually writing a scientific paper. If you're writing a scientific paper, also please consider citing us if you're using this software. And you can cite us by using this citation here, that you can find it here in the footer of the website. If you want to check our source code, you can do so by clicking here at the bottom, and you will be redirected to our source code on GitHub. And inside here, you can find all the functions. You can also contribute to the code if you want to, or you can open issues. So here you can go to issues, and then you can open a new issue if you find a bug in our tool. Alternatively, we also provided a link to submit issues here at the bottom in the footer. And we have a YouTube channel in which we explain how to use our tool. And we have released a video similar to this one, so you can check that out. I really hope you find this video interesting. If you have any question, please feel free to write a comment down in the, under the video, or you can contact us by going here in help, and then you will find an email that you can use to contact us. So you can write us at cbecomforttool@gmail.com. Thank you very much for listening, and see you in the next video.